Hey everyone, how's your Friday going so far? Mine's going pretty well. Aren't you glad the week's over? I know I sure am. Okay, I know. I can't even pretend it's Friday this time. I apologize. I haven't really been feeling at 100% lately. I know that's not much of an excuse. But the video is going up, and hopefully it makes up a little bit for Wednesday's short video. Now, here, we could go down into the guts of the ship, where there are numerous really obnoxious enemies, and there's a few fruit down there, and I think there's an elixir. But really, see, this enemy in particular, he throws his sword at you almost immediately, and he gives you zero time to react. And there are a bunch of him down if you go into the ship. But we're not going into the ship. We would, like I said, there's some items. There's not actually anything up here. I'm just, I don't know why this area is here, if they didn't put something here. You'd think there would be a chest or something up there. But I haven't been able to find anything. However, being able to walk up these ropes gives you, as Gaul, access to a pretty useful shortcut. And this is how I like to do things. This jump is almost impossible to make, but persist and you will make it. And you can bypass a large, really, really shitty part of this level. And I know I said this video would be longer, and it will be a little bit longer, since we have a boss fight coming up that's almost identical to, but a little trickier than the previous one. But I don't want to go into the ship. That does not strike me as a good idea. I want to go on ahead and use an apple, since we're going to need 100% health with Gaul in a minute. But first, I'm going to switch to Tap, because there's an enemy down here that you need a very long range attack with, because he has a very long range attack. And if I walk towards him, I'm just going to get hit, so I'm going to wait for him to turn around and come back onto the screen. He has like this hook thing on a rope that he swings at you, and it is fast. Oops, not male. Actually, I'll switch to male just for the dialogue. But then we're going to use Gaul for the actual fight.
Well, hello there. So glad you could make it. I've been expecting you. You bested my twin, but don't think you even stand a chance against me.
What have you done with King Lips? If he's been hurt, you'll regret it.
Oh, don't get in a huff. Lips is safe and sound in the Crystal Tower. For now, that is. Face it, you don't stand a chance of retrieving either him or the orbs, so just go home. I'm tired of looking at you.
If you think I'm taking that advice, think again, sister.
Foolish imp. Time to die.
And we are going to, Oh, God. Sorry about that. I was fixing the audio. I don't know why she called male an imp. She calls Gaul an imp in that dialogue, which kind of makes sense. Sorry, my voice is hoarse lately. She calls Gaul an imp, which makes sense, but I don't know. Anyway, I left and came back so I could save and. Just in case this fight goes south. Like I said, it's going to be pretty similar to the last one. She does have a few attacks that add a wrinkle or two into this fight. But it should not be that much more difficult than the fight against Wraph. The trick is to use Gaul's Breath in short controlled bursts to keep your ammo as long as possible. And that's it. That was not even a fraction as difficult as I was expecting it to be. Because she has this wave attack that she uses that travels along the ground.
How can this simple urge have beaten me? But no matter. The Overlord will avenge my death.
So yeah, she had a wave attack that she could have used, and she had like this three-pronged attack that could hit you even all the way in the corner like that. But she didn't use either of them, so. So yeah, I guess it's going to be another short one. Let's head up here and just see what these guys have to say.
Hey, help! You again? I see you finally found the perfect home. What did you do this time?
But I didn't do anything this time. I was captured and caned mercilessly. The spray paint wasn't even mine. By God, you've gotta believe me.
You expect me to believe that?
No, really. I'm telling the truth. One minute I was talking to Lips, and the next we were in this creepy coffin factory.
Lips? The king? How can that be? God knows he's in the Crystal Tower!
He's an imposter! The Overlord had his flunkies plan this so their fake king could lead the people into ruin!
Yeah! I saw Wraph and the fake Lips talking in the hall. That stinking imposter had the blue orb.
Oh, I was afraid of that. Can't there be any easy tasks on this quest?
You can't wallow in self-pity. You've got to get the blue orb back and stop the imposter king. I'm afraid I can't be of much help now. It seems as if you are the only hope for our land.
And, more importantly, the only hope of springing us out of this cruddy cell.
Well then, I guess it's up to me to stop the imposter and recover the orb. But don't worry, God has everything under control.
Huh. I guess God has everything under control. And it's all up to him, apparently. So yeah, that'll do it. Tune in on Monday for yet another episode of Let's Play Popful Male Redux. I'm Duke of the Bump, and I will see you later.